Good afternoon to everyone. Welcome to DCEB Suryapet and Khammam District Biological Science online classes. This is Farzana Begum, CRT Bioscience, KGBV Raghunathapalayam, Khammam District. Children, as we know, we all are going to discuss about in the chapter of challenges in improving agriculture products. In that chapter, today we are going to discuss about today's topic, organic farming. Okay children, so in that topic we are able to understand after completion of this lesson what is organic farming. What is organic farming? What is organic farming? What are biofertilizers? What are biofertilizers? Biofertilizers. Identification of nitrogen fixers. Identification of nitrogen fixers. Nitrogen fixers. Write the names of bio factors. Write the examples of biofertilizers. Fertilizers. Define microbial culture. Define microbial culture. Yes children, these all are we know about after completion of this chapter. Okay, organic farming. What is organic farming children? Organic farming means using biofertilizers instead of chemical fertilizers and synthesized pyrethroids to get high yield is known as organic farming. What is organic farming? Children, see here. Organic farming means using biofertilizers instead of chemical fertilizers. What is organic farming children? Using biofertilizers instead of chemical fertilizers and synthesized pyrethroids to get high yield is known as organic farming. Okay children? Yes. Using biofertilizers. What are biofertilizers? We will discuss later. In simple, biofertilizers means we can get the nutrients from environment to from the soil. Okay. So these are biofertilizers. And synthesized pyrethroids means utilizing insecticides. Pyrethroids means insecticides means which can kill the insect is called insecticide. A chemical which can kill insects is called insecticide. Okay children, insecticide means a chemical which can kill insect is called insecticide. That is another name is pyrethroids. To get high yield is known as organic farming. This is called organic farming. Okay, children, using biofertilizers instead of chemical fertilizers and synthesized pyrethroids to get high yield is known as organic farming. So when we are using chemical fertilizers, we want more high yield productivity of the crop production, then we are using chemical fertilizers instead of biofertilizers. So now we will discuss now what are the examples, what are the advantages of the organic fertilizers we will discuss. So organic farming means, organic farming is an agricultural system that originated in the 20th century, in the early 20th century. So in the early 20th century, the organic farming will be agricultural system. It will be developed rapidly to be changing farming practices. Changing agriculture farming practices, they will be rapidly changes. 20th century. After the 20th century, organic farming is an agriculture system is to be developed in various organizations today. Number of organizations till today after 20th century. Then these organic farming will be develops an agriculture system that is ecologically based part organization agriculture system ecologically based part controls agriculture system ecologically based part controls. But biological fertilizers they will be derived from plants and animal waste products, that is, and animal dung means animal which they will be excrete the organs which is excrete urinaries and dung. Plant, there will be dry leaves, branches, this all. And nitrogen fixers cover crops, to cover the crops. These all helpful to soil productivity. They can give the agriculture formation will be developed. Next, after this agriculture system will be they get high yield productivity of the farmers when we are using chemical fertilizers. We are using why we are using chemical fertilizers? 20 to 30 years they will be get high yield. After 30 years after, the soil recollection to plant growth. Okay, recollection to plant growth, the soil productivity will be damaged. The chemical fertilizers are used to soil productivity will damage, soil health is not proper, then it will be it is not utilized to fertilizers, best fertilizers. After otherwise the soil fertility will be mere waste. So these are, so when a long term high yield productivity we can get the availability of long term productivity, soil productivity, we can get a high yield amount of crops, then where do we can get? From the best soil fertility, physical and chemical nutrients, physical, chemical, biological factors of the nutrients in the soil there, that can give the best soil fertility in our crops. Okay, these are the uses of the organic farming culture. That soil productivity will be helps into a to grow into new best crops, to grow high yield capacity of the crops. These capacity will be farmers using the ancient came into existence ancient times of the ancient days to farmers, they are using some of the methods. So some of the methods they are using, which is natural manure to development of the crops. Natural manure they are using. So another method is natural pest controlling methods, natural pest controlling methods, natural pest controlling methods. Next, also as the part of crop rotation, and also as the part of mixed crops. These four changes they are using farmers, they forming agriculture system, they are forming organic farmings, they are using without pesticides, they can get high yield, nutrient, soil productivity. These all are the helpful to the grow the best yield. Okay, these methods they are using farmers. After them, some of the microorganisms which are useful to synthesize nutrients from environment and to soil. Okay, from environment and to soil. This is known as microbial cultures and biofertilizers. Okay, so we can see next some of the microorganisms which is useful to synthesize nutrients. Useful to some of the microorganisms which is useful to synthesize nutrients to environment. Where do we get microorganisms? From the environment to from the plants, from the soil to plants. Okay, so from the soil and environment both we can get from the synthesized nutrients. So these are called microbial culture. Okay children, microbial culture or biofertilizer. So biofertilizers or microbial culture means some of the microorganisms which is useful to synthesize nutrients to environment or from the soil to the plants. So where do we get the plants? From the soil or environment, they can get the best nutrients from the soil. So these are called microbial cultures or biofertilizers. Okay, so generally biofertilizers are two types. How many types of biofertilizers? There are two types. So first one is nitrogen fixers. First one is nitrogen fixer, and second one is phosphorus moralizer and phosphorus solubilizer. Okay, so biofertilizers are divided into two parts, that is nitrogen fixers and phosphorus moralizers and phosphorus solubilizer. So nitrogen fixers, where do we can see? From the environment or from the soil. So nitrogen fixers, here nitrogen fixers means transforming atmospheric nitrogen into fixed nitrogen. Okay, transforming atmospheric nitrogen into fixed nitrogen, that is called nitrogen fixers. In these nitrogen fixers, mostly we can observe azotobacteria, rhizobium. These are bacterial forms. Next, one more nitrogen fixers, that is blue green algae. Okay, this is nitrogen fixers. And one more example of biofertilizers, that is one more part, that is phosphorus moralizers and phosphorus solubilizer. So this phosphorus moralizer or phosphorus solubilizer, where do we can get from the soil? So moralizers, example of mycorrhiza. What is the example of moralizer, children? Mycorrhiza. Okay, solubilizer. What is the example of solubilizer, children? Here, penicillin. Penicillin. This is the examples of biofertilizer. Next, coming to the next, these biofertilizer, come children, here. We can see this is the flow chart of biofertilizer. So biofertilizers are synthesized from the microorganisms. So these microorganisms, where do we get, children? Where do we get? From the bacteria, from the algae, from the fungi. So these all are, we can get biofertilizers. So bacteria comes from nitrogen fixers, phosphorus solubilizers. So nitrogen fixer is the example of rhizobium bacteria, azotobacter bacteria, isosporidium bacteria. So phosphorus solubilizer is the example of bacillus pseudomonas. Next one is algae, which is from nitrogen fixers, that is example of blue-green algae. Next, coming to the next, that is fungi. So fungi is phosphorus moralizers and phosphorus solubilizer. So moralizer is the example, mycorrhiza, phosphorus solubilizer, penicillium. So children, did you observe in this flow chart? Yes, no? Shall I ask one more question from you? What did you observe in this flow chart? So where do we get this flow chart? Why should we write here? So these are coming from the biofertilizers in this flow chart. Bacteria, algae, fungi converts into biofertilizers. These are converts into biofertilizers, that is bacteria, algae and fungi. Next, another one is, children, can you identify what are the major nutrients from the biofertilizers? What are the major nutrients from the biofertilizers? These are major nutrients. See here, nitrogen, here phosphorus, nitrogen, phosphorus moralizer, phosphorus solubilizer. So common names, what did you observe here? Common names are, you can observe here. What are common names? Nitrogen, nitrogen. Phosphorus, phosphorus, phosphorus. So what are the major nutrients ma here? Nitrogen and phosphorus. Nitrogen and phosphorus are the major nutrients from the synthesized biofertilizers. Okay, do you understand? Yes. Coming to the biofertilizers, next, that is biofertilizers are useful to maintain soil health and productivity. So these biofertilizers will be helps into soil health, soil fertility, soil productivity, to improve the soil nourishment, nutrients. These all are, they can cover the biofertilizers, mean to synthesize microorganisms to help the soil fertility, smooth, fertile soil, to give the best yield to the crop. Okay, so this is, so these do not have nutrients, these do not have nutrients in them like organic manure. These do not have nutrients like organic manure, but they synthesize nutrients from the, where do we can get these nutrients? From the environment or from the soil, both. So who will get in this, children? Environment and soil, these two will be helps into a, to grow best fertilizer. So that's why we can call this environment is eco-friendly environment or eco-friendly fertilizers. Farmers friendly fertilizers we can call. So in this nitrogen fixers like microorganisms we can buy, the children, we cannot buy. Where do we get? Only for the soil. So soil nutrients will be cheap. Only for the nourishment, best nutrients will be helps us. So we cannot buy it. They are cheap. So these nutrition values, they are in cheap. That we cannot buy. they are best soil fertility, adds nutrients in the soil. Next, water absorb holding capacity from water holding capacity. So next, water holding capacity. Next, soil fertility will be best soil fertility, eco-forming, friendly nature. Next, nature forming when the water and soil will be fresh. So fresh soil will be available, that soil fertility will be smooth, that crop will be growing. Then, so these all are the, and this zero budget means they are cheap. So this is the nature. We health, if we are cultivate the some of the crops, we can eat, we can get best health in our product ourselves. Okay, so this is the biofertilizer. So biofertilizers are these, come synthesized from the nutrients like so environment or soil, we can call biofertilizers. Okay children, let us continue the topic, organic farming. So types of organic farming. So here, types of organic farming means we need to best soil we can cultivate. Types of organic farming, that is biofarming. That is biofarming. Biofarming means the biofertilizers, biological fertilizers like plants derived from the plants and animal waste and nitrogen fixers to cover the crops. These are all biofarming, biofertilizers. They cannot buy, we cannot buy that. So they can give the best soil, best productivity for us. So that is nature farming. And it's another one is organic farming. Another structure is nature farming. So nature gives us best soil, soil fertility. We cannot pollute that soil. Water holding capacity of the soil. So these all are utilizing sunlight, everything will be air, water, we can utilizing. So we can give the best yield to the crops, that is will be helps to growing best organic farming. Next, without pollution organic farming we can farm. Eco farming, we can get eco friendly farming, we can get without fertilizers we are using, like environment from the soil both we are using, we are cultivate, synthesize the nutrients, we can get the best eco farming. Next, biodynamic farming means we can get best soil productivity. That soil productivity will be helps in to the growing best crops. So soil productivity will be depends upon the biological, physical, chemical, agricultural products like soil fertility. We can some protection our from the soil erosions. So these kind of biodynamic farming. Next, zero budget farming. So there is no investment for that. Organic farming, we can do the best soil enough. Without pesticides we are using. So this is zero budget. There is no amount of, there is no investment for that. So we can cultivate best crops, best vegetables, best fruits. These all are helpful to human health, hygienic purpose. So nowadays we are using pandemic situation, all chemicals we are using. So all chemical food items. So we are before cutting vegetables and fruits we are washing. So without pesticides we do not, only just we wash it and we can eat them. So raw vegetables also we should eat them. So that is the importance of the organic farming. These organic farming will be helps into a better hygienic health conditions. So this health will be, so organic foods, nowadays number of members depends on soil productivity, best soil productivity, best organic foods we prefer. So a small kids to and old elders, they will be get a number of diseases. So thus that diseases we can avoid from, we can take organic food items, organic farming. So come children here. So did you observe, what are you observe here? These all are organic food items. Organic food items we can cultivate from in our garden only, children. So these organic farming tends to be better environment. Better environment we can cultivate these crops. So in our surrounding only we are using soil nutrients and water holding water. Soil from the nutrients, environment which give the air, atmospheric nitrogen they are using. So without pesticides we are using. We can cultivate these fruits and vegetables, children. So these are helpful to our health. Okay, children. These are helpful to our health. So we can build our health better. We can give the knowledge from others. We can organic fruits are, it is very helpful for us. So without pesticides, we are using this organic food items. And coming to next, see children. So after we can summarize some of the points here. So what we can summarize about this topic, organic farming. Okay, what we can summarize, children, see here. Organic farming, did you hear now? So what is organic farming, ma? Using biofertilizers instead of chemical fertilizers. And synthesized pyrethroids to get high yield is known as organic farming. So pyrethroid means insecticide. Insecticides means a chemical which we can kill the insects is called insecticides. Okay, so here biofertilizers means to synthesize nutrients from the environment and the soil. Okay, children, yes, did you understand that? Yes. Next, coming to after completion of this organic farming, of the 20th century agriculture system, they will be developed, rapidly changing farming practices, and they will be developed derived from the plants and animal waste production, nitrogen fixers, this all are will help students to cover the crops. So these cover the after ancient times, so farmers using natural manure, natural pest control methods, crop rotation, mixed crops, these all are the methods farmers they are using. They cultivate the crops, they can grow soil productivity, so they can give the best yield for the crops. So next is some of the microorganisms which are useful to synthesize nutrients from the environment, from the soil to plants. These are called microbial nutrients and are biofertilizers. Okay, children, so microbial culture are biofertilizers. Biofertilizers are two types, that is nitrogen fixers, phosphorus moralizers and phosphorus solubilizer. Nitrogen fixers are atmospheric nitrogen, they can fix air into the soil. So that is examples of Azotobacteria, Rhizobium. Next, which is algae, that is blue green algae. So phosphorus moralizer, examples of here, phosphorus and phosphorus moralizer, solubilizer, both inorganic solubles to can be soluble from the organic matters, that is soil. So examples of moralizer, mycorrhiza. Examples of solubilizer, Penicillium. Okay, now so these biofertilizers, they can get a indication of the flow chart. In this flow chart, we can identify about the main nutrients, nitrogen and phosphorus. Okay, children, these are synthesized from the microbial nutrients. You understand? So what is eco-friendly fertilizers? So biofertilizers, to maintain soil health and productivity, they do not have any nutrients like manure, organic manure, but they synthesize only for the environment and the soil. This is organic biofertilizers. So these are called eco-friendly fertilizers. Farmers, eco-friendly fertilizers, they can give the best for the farmers with the cheap means with cheap material, cheaper. So that's why organic farming, the farmers will be cultivated with the help of biofarming, like derived from the plant and animal biological waste materials. Nature farming, like soil productivity, water holding capacity. Eco farming means eco friendly, like environment, soil, all it will be biodynamic soil productivity practices, zero budget, they are in cheap soil productivity. So these all are including soil productivity. Next, we can get the best yield of organic farming to cultivate the organic food materials. So these organic food materials, when we cultivate, they can get, they are in cheap. They do not have any investment, zero budget. Best nutrients, adds in best nutrients in the soil, water holding capacity, best soil fertility, soil productivity based on biological waste materials. They are in cheap. So these all are friendly fertilizers for the farmers. So they are in easy budget for us. So that's why we can prefer from the organic food items. So children, every home you should be prefer from the organic fertilizers, organic food varieties. We can suggest your mothers that food will be health, best health for us, wealth, health and hygiene. Without pesticides we are using now leafy vegetables, number of leafy vegetables, number of vegetables, fruits, we are using organic fertilizers, organic farmings. So these you should be prefer from your home. After, did you understand the children about this organic farming topic? Yes. Just we can evaluate ourselves. Okay, what did you observe starting to now? So what are organic farming? Okay, what are organic farming? What are biofertilizers? Are microbial cultures? Identification of nitrogen fixes. Okay, you identified now? Yes. Write the examples of biofertilizers. How many types of biofertilizers? How many types are there biofertilizers? So define microbial culture. Next, write the flowchart of biofertilizers. So these all you should write and show to your teacher. Then she will correct and send. Next, so you understand about. I hope you understand all this topic, children. Yes. So let us meet you next class. Thank you.